Now we will move to our clock tree tab. Then on the left side, you can see our clock sources. The blue one are the active. That is the high speed internal oscillator here set for the 16 MHz. And low speed internal RC oscillator here set for the 32 kHz. Be careful, these values can be different for each microcontroller and also number of the clock sources. For example, the L devices have also the multi-speed internal oscillator, which we don't have here. We have here also some additional clock sources like the high speed external oscillator and low speed external oscillator. But you can see they are gray. This means they are not active. But if we hold the mouse there, and usually the CubeMX trying to help us, and he advises us to enable the IP in the RCC pinout tab. Then if we want the external oscillator, we can here move to the pinout. We find the RCC periphery and we enable the external clock sources here as the crystal, here also the low speed. You can see in the pinout the pins was automatically assigned to the oscillators. If we return now, you can see the external clock sources are now blue, then we can use them. For the low speed external, we cannot change the frequency because this is usually fixed to have the 1 second precision. But the high speed, we can also here set the correct value. On our Nucleo kit, in case you have the Nucleo kit like me, I know that there is the external signal. There is no crystal or the oscillator, but the signal then with the frequency 8 MHz, that in case we will use the external one, we can use the external 8 MHz value. Now, what we can see more? We can see that we have here also the multiplexers. Then we can set the source code for the different part of the core. Here, for example, for the system clock, I can set also the high-speed external oscillator. You can see here the value was immediately changed, or the internal high-speed oscillator. And also I can set here the PL block. Now if I select here the PL, you can see that something is wrong. If I point here the mouse, you can see the maximum frequency can be here only the 84 MHz. Then I need to change something. Then the PL, I think you definitely know the PL. PL is used for the multiplying the frequencies. In the STM32, we have 1, 2, 3 or more PLs with 1, 2 or 3 outputs. Then what we can set? Here, before the PL, we have usually need to set the clock source. Here I can use the external high-speed oscillator. You can see again something is wrong. He's telling me that the frequency must be higher than 0.95 MHz and equal or smaller than 2.1 MHz. Then for the better computation, I here set the 8 to have 8 MHz on the input divided by 8. Then here it's input 1 MHz multiplied by 192 and divided here by 2, which goes into the core. Then here I definitely need to set something which will be equal to the 84, which will be, for example, 168, if I'm right. Yes, and you can see now the frequency is correct. then this helped me with the selection or the settings, the clocks. But it's not the all. You can also set the divider for the AHB bridge. Then after this AHB bridge on the right side, you can see what is the destination of this clock source. For the after AHB bridge Pascaler, you can see there are the HCLK value, and this value now divided only by 1 is used for the AHB bus, for the core, for the memories, and for the DMA. Then this helped me to discover what will be my clock frequency. Then this is it's this first value. Then we can see the second value. It's also the Cortex SysTick timer, which can be set also for the different frequency, can be also divided by 8. It's the core timer, which is always embedded inside the core with the ARM, and it's used mainly for the keeping the 1 millisecond time base, usually for the FreeRTOS system. The FCLK clock I use for the floating point subsystem, which is embedded inside the core. Usually M-core, M4 cores and the M7 have this signal. You cannot change it, it must be on the same frequency as the core. On the different cores like the M0, M3, you not find this signal. But most important, I think, is the APB bridges. You can see the APB1 bridge is set incorrectly. Why? Because here is written the maximum frequency. Maximum frequency you can check also in the datasheet. Then here is 42. Then I can set here 42, and you see everything is okay. The APB bridge also provides the PCLK clock 1. These clocks I use for the all peripherals which are connected to the APB1 bridge. But not all the peripherals except the timers, because the timers have the separated clock source. And you can see in this case are multiplied by 2, then the timers can run on the same frequency as the core. It's very, very good in case you have very precise application which need to have very precise timers. And the APB2, you can see the maximum frequency of the APB2 is a little bit different. It's here again the 84 megahertz. Then the peripherals which are on the APB2 can run on the same frequency as the core. This is not valid for the OR microcontrollers. Depend which do you have. If you have the F401 like me, it will be valid the 84. And you can see the timers are here multiplied only with the 1. In case that I divide here the frequency by 2, here the timers are automatically multiplied by 2 on the same frequency. But the 2 is maximum for the timer multiplication, is done by automatic. If the Pascaler is different from 1, it's automatically multiplied. Then in case you have 4, the 2 is the maximum for the timers.